ball and I'm 7'3". I'm telling you, man, I only play men's sports, like football and hopscotch.
Hopscotch? That's a girl's game.
Man, that ain't a girl's game, man. Not rugby hopscotch. Man, get me in a scrum and I'll dance. I'll take anybody dance. I'm the hopscotch master. I got swag skills in hopscotch, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I mean, I kind of see your point, but, you know, you'd be a little cranky, too, if your empire had fallen apart over the last 100 years. And speaking of commerce, it's time for some commerce here. Let's go to commercials. We'll be back after this.
Has your marriage gone stale? Has the spark gone out of your lovers?
I'm gonna get you.
Thank you for retrieving those packages, but they were only a decoy. Sorry about that, but that's sometimes the way in business. My real objective was hidden on the plane all along. Unfortunately, the Port Authority seized the plane and were stripping it down until I intervened at great personal expense. Cross the bridge to Shoreside Vale and go to Francis International Airport. I've paid off the officials. My property will be waiting for you at the customs hangar in the aircraft fuselage.
You'll get no argument from me. I mean, I get every inconsiderate moron in Liberty City calling into this show. I mean...
Veterans, we fought for your freedom. When I came back from the Australian-American War, I didn't get a hero's welcome. I didn't get a pat on the back from my friends and neighbors saying,
Thank you for fighting for our freedom, Jack. After years of fighting in the trenches, I come back here and everyone's watching TV.
Now, can you tell me what this Australian-American war was? I mean, I really never heard of it.
God, not another one. Have you read a history book lately, son? The Australian-American war was the biggest war since the big one. I tell you, I didn't see two tours to take boomerang shrapnel in my head so I can come back here and have a bunch of hippies denied history.
Oh, thanks for the history lesson. All right, let's go over here. Hello, caller. You're on Chatterbox.
Yeah? Is that you, Aslo?
Yes, it is. Who's this?
My name ain't important. It's real unimportant, okay?
No, not really. I mean, this is a radio show. People usually tell us their name.
My name is real unimportant. If you want to keep being a wise guy, you'll find out just how unimportant. Like, unimportant, I just got shot in the head. Unimportant. Do I make myself clear?
Yes. Why are you calling in today?
Because I need some advice, and I ain't doing any of that shrink shit.
If you swear again, we're gonna have to cut you off. This is a family show.
Sorry. I'm just a little unhappy. I've been agitated. Real angry. It's my mom. She don't think I'm a real man. Can you imagine that? I mean, I do a man's job and all, but she treats me like a little boy. All I get is your paw this and your paw that, and you ain't a real man, Tony. Freaking nuts.
Well, Tony.
Tony? How'd you know my name was Tony? You're tracing this call.
Hey, let's get this out of here. God knows what it is, but he seems to want it badly enough, so it must be worth something.
Who the hell?
You!
Hey, take it easy, amigo. No es nada, no es nada.
I left you pouring your heart out into the gutter!
Hey, don't shoot, amigo. No problem. We all friends.
Don't be such a pussy!
Hey, we got no choice, baby.
We always got a choice, you dumb bastard.
I'm sorry about the crazy bitch, man. They're all the same, please. Por favor.
So, the whore got away. But you've done me a favor. You're not the only one that has a score to settle with the cartel. This worm killed my brother.
I never killed no Yakuza!
Liar! We all saw the cartel assassin. We are going to hunt down and kill all you Colombian dogs. I'll be operating on our friend here to extract information and a little pleasure. You, drop by later. I'm sure I'll require your services.
Please, amigo! Don't leave me here with her, man. She's psycho, chico, man. Please, amigo. Hey, amigo! Amigo!
Thank you. player hater.
Freaking out. a damn thing. My guy got a better car than you.
Check out the Zeppelin.
My guy can give a
Here you go, Pogo. Have a fast car.
And help Pogo to his final mission, to storm the White House with his friends and become President of the United States. Pogo the Monkey is the game kids are sure to stare at for hours. Everyone loves Pogo. Idiot Gamer called Pogo the best spring and sim... has everything. Why not a Pogo the Monkey tie-in sports jacket? For the lady in your life, why not Pogo the Monkey chocolates and hygiene products so she smells like a real monkey? And for kids, a life-size, living, breathing, springing monkey. All available at PogoTheMonkey.com.
All right, Liberty City, this is your talk radio show, Chatterbox, where your opinion matters. Let's go to the phones. Hello, caller, you're on Chatterbox.
Hey, you ever had possum? Good eat.
No. I'd use the Dormatron, unlike those other...
Pogo to his final mission, to storm the White House with his friends and become President of the United States. Pogo the Monkey is the game kids are sure to stare at for hours. Everyone loves Pogo. Idiot Gamer called Pogo the best spring and simian game since Bouncing Bananas. Buy the game Pogo the Monkey today. Right, Pogo? And coming soon, Pogo the Monkey... Kids, a life-size, living, breathing, springy monkey. All available at PogoTheMonkey.com.
Now, 10 minutes of music guaranteed. As soon as you wait through another 9 minutes of messages from our sponsors. Lips 106.
I'm a marketing manager who lives in the suburbs and commutes to work on the highway. I live alone, so of course I needed a car that can see 12 and is equipped to drive across Arctic tundra. It just makes me feel better.
The new My Boxy Monstrosity. Mine is bigger.
L-I-P-S-106. Commercial.
Thank you.
Interlude Radio. I'm Michael Hunt. You can call me Mike. With another fat jam of nonstop rock from the station that can give you more because we pay our employees less.
Built from cheap labor from Zambia, El Salvador, and Paraguay. This is Head Radio.
I used to be concerned and nervous about the future. Sometimes I'd get scared before an important event such as childbirth or a family funeral. Hey, sometimes you need a little help navigating life's trouble spots. That's when I discovered Equinox.
After the divorce and losing little Tommy, life was getting me down. I couldn't focus on anything at all. After trying Equinox, I've been employee of the month 3 times in a row.
I used to fall unconscious for hours at a time. Now with Equinox, I never need to sleep.
Equinox is new from Zaibatsu Pharmaceuticals. Ask your doctor about Equinox today.
Equinox may cause motion, loss of sleep, blurred vision, leakage, kidney problems, and breathing abilities. Not take Equinox if you're operating heavy machinery, driving a car, pregnant, a childbearing age, on average, family history, and dental
concerns. Equinox, softening life's harsh reality.
Here's one that brings down the house when I do my weekly Michael Hunt's Rock and Roll Jam at Liberty City's premier bowling alley. I'm Mike Wheels of Steel Hunt. I know she's sad. She swings her hips and her bits. What she makes, what she brings. I sing it's all good, but she can hide from
me. Clavo, is that your real name?
Of course it's my real name.
Are you from Gary?
No, I'm from upstate.
Are you sure that's not a fake radio name like Andy or Bobo? I thought all those radio people had fake names.
Do you have a question or you just want to sit here?
There's no need to feel bad.
And entertainment together.
All right, hello, next caller. You're on Chatterbox.
I want to talk about that bang stuff. It's bad. It's not bad to you at all. Why aren't you talking? Oh, you think I'm strange? Am I on the air? Hello? It's me, Pansy.
What's your question?
Bang, 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 bang!
What about it? I mean, that's not really a question. Questions usually start with words like how and why, and they end with your voice going up like this.
Don't mock me. I know where you are. You're just another rapper.
How's...
Cotton, making cream, look!
messages.
Now out.
I used to be concerned and nervous about the future. Sometimes I'd get scared before an important event such as childbirth or a family funeral. Hey, sometimes you need a little help.
Chatterbox, call us on the chatter line to tell us what's on your mind. Line 4, you're on chat. Line 2. Hello, caller.
But you play the lottery. And now that they lost the tax on money, Oh, hey.
Good point. I think that's a lesson to us all. All right. Hello, you are on Chatterbox.
Hello, Doctor. I'm a first-time caller. I need to move.
There's excellent child care here in America.
Well, I'm sure. But the thing is, man, when I was a naughty boy, I would get spanked. Nanny would spank me.
Oh, then you're freaking on.
Now.
How old is your son?
Excuse me?
How old is
is your son.
I have children. I can't stand it for that. But I'm sick.
Station. Remember, it's not a conflict of interest if we own all the radio stations in town. We'll be right back after this message.
In today's fast-paced world, a split second can be the difference between achieving your dreams. More Americans are realizing if you don't have the latest and greatest technological devices, you will fall behind.
I didn't upgrade my personal organizer, and 2 days later I was diagnosed with a terminal illness.
That's exactly why you should come visit the friendly people at House of Tomorrow, and they'll set you up with all your 21st century technology needs.
I only spent $20,000, and now I can get email in the shower or surf the internet while I'm driving. I was bored stupid at my daughter's recitals and my son's Little League games. Thanks to House of Tomorrow, I can play wire.
Of Tomorrow, we'll upgrade your system, then you can upgrade your life.
And now it is my great pleasure to welcome Fernando Martinez.
Many, many arts. Be skilled in making house, cooking, changing the diapers on the baby. And she must also be a whore, a vixen in the bedroom, imaginative, exotic, constantly fresh. It is impossible. You change diapers and then you are a French maid? Fernando thinks not. Fernando knows not.
Well, I mean, you know, it's an age-old problem. I mean, how do you keep the excitement in a marriage?
Excitement, exactly. Passion, danger. How, Laszlo? How? Tell me how, and I give you a big, big kiss, like I give a woman. But I am not going to give you a big kiss. Not a kiss like I give a woman, or even a donkey.
I'm going to get you.
Hey, Smell-a-Pesh!
Take my cigar!
Am I not attractive? Am I not irresistible
what
even to you?
Doing?
Well, no matter. Why all this talking about kissing?
I mean, you brought it up.
No, my friend. You say, you not want to kiss me. I was talking how to say, hypothetically, you make me all personal.
Not my art.
Damn fully.
Damn pussy.
You ain't no gentleman.
That's my friend.
Anyway,
the marriage is impossible, Laszlo. If a man was born an angel, maybe impossible. But a man is born a man. And a man with knees. He needs a woman to tuck his babies into the bed. But for his bed, he needs something else. Something magical. Under his arms. Sueño.
So he starts flirting with the secretary, takes her out for a drink. One thing leads to another, and before you know it, he's found all kinds of uses for the office furniture.
Exactly, Laszlo. I know what you are like. I see it in your eyes. I want a dreamer.
It's your daddy.
Off to the hex, we got the rascal away to the crowd. It's a break now.
Your marriage is a gift.
Get out of my dressing
room. You are a man. think we see by now you are no angel. What then, my friend? What then?
I get a sexual harassment suit.
If you are lucky, but you more likely, your marriage is ruined. Your sweetheart, she hates you. Your pretty secretary, she wants you to be her man. You back into square one. My friend, you and 1,000 men like you. For me, once it was so. But then one day, I was driving my car, and I realized, Fernando, you are blessed. You are a miracle. A 1,000 miracles roll into one. You save the marriage, and you save... No, this is a bad name. It sounds really dumb. Then I think we call it Fernando's New Beginnings, because that is what it means, a new beginning.
So how does this work?
It is a miracle, Laszlo, a miracle. A man is a good father and a good husband. The winner of bread, six beggars, basically. And the spare half day, I save his life.
How?
By giving him what he needs and a control of
him.
I give him passion.
What, with you? That kind of sounds like a limited mark.
You are very prejudiced. You like that. But no, not with me. Passion for life. Passion for love. Passion for women. Which he can take home.
What, so you act like a pimp?
Not a pimp, a savior. In a control environment, I reintroduce the man to the pleasure he has lost, to the miracles of the world. And truly, the results are remarkable. With my unique counseling, I thought... If every day...
And do the wives know about this?
In their hearts, Laszlo, they know they have been saved.
Okay. We're gonna open it up to the phones if you've got any questions for Fernando Martinez, exotic marriage guide.
She gives Jerry 5 kids, but she's even bigger. Now, she's like a whole offensive line. He feels no pride in himself. He has no pride in his marriage. He is ashamed of this wonderful lady who bears him so many young. And he comes to me and he cries, Fernando, save my marriage. I love my wife, even though she is a fat porker. And I say, Jerry, you are a man. It is a man's duty to love his wife, even if she is like a farmer. And now, Jerry is saved.
By sleeping with other women.
Whatever it takes to save
a beautiful union by an adulterer and Queen Kong. That's great. So, who's on the line now?
Hi, Laszlo. Jen. I love the show and always wanted to call in. You really offended me today. Who is this gutter trash you got on the show?
Hey, Janice, I share your anxiety. The studio kind of forced me.
Go to New Beginning, she thinks Senor Wonderful are over here. In the extreme case, maybe she comes to work for me. And she gets a new beginning herself. She discovered the excitement and the passion all for herself. This is Janice, you called me Cinco, Cinco, Cinco.
Latin.
I do not need to listen to these insults. I have pride. I have a calling. Many are called, but few are chosen, my friend. And I was called and chosen to work a miracle.
So...
Just log on to PetsOvernight.com and we'll send you a cute kitten overnight. PetsOvernight.com, delivering little bundles of love in a box directly to your door.
And now it's time for a public service announcement from station owner Donald Love.
Hello, my name is Donald Love. You're listening to a Love Media station. Enjoy.
All right, we're back here on Chatterbox, the radio show that never gets old. I'm Laszlo with open ears and a closed mind. Hello, you're on the air. What's your name?
I wanted to talk about spanking.
Oh, God, not another one.
I think spanking kids is the only way to teach them right from wrong.
So you think that teaching kids at an early age that violence is the solution to problems will make them valuable members of our society?
Exactly. I knew you'd understand, Laszlo. My daddy used to whoop the tar out of me. He once hit me so hard my spleen fell out of my ear. Didn't do me no harm. Look at me now. Rats, roaches, vermin than you can imagine, and I love it. This is such a great country. I wouldn't be where I am today if my daddy hadn't beat me senseless.
What are you talking about? Man, I'm starting to believe that guy about the fluoride in the drinking water. Listen, if there's any sane person left in Liberty City that can hear my voice, please call the show right now. This is SOS going out across the city. All right, let's go over to this line. Hello, caller. You are on the air. Are you sane? Are you a sane caller?
Absolutely, Laszlo. Killer bees.
Killer bees?
Yes, killer bees. Did you know that if the current migration not continues, we will... I don't. That's why we must act now. Killer bees must be stopped.
I wonder why more people aren't talking about this. I mean, killer bees swarming, it sounds pretty serious.
Ah, but the killer bees are nothing compared to ants. You can't kill them. They're like sheep. They're going to take over.
All right, thanks, caller. Ants, killer bees, fat people, what's plaguing you? Call now. Chatterbox.
In the city, whoever yells on and on into their cell phone, I'm really glad to get to hear about what you're having for dinner. What we should do is first them up, put them on an island. I am the president of a group called Citizens Raging Against the Phone.
Crap?
Exactly.
Your organization's called Crap. What kind of moron are you? You want to round people up for using a phone, but you're calling up on a phone to tell the world about it. I mean, how many people are there in this crap?
Citizens are raging against phones, Laszlo.
How many people?
There are three of us. It's hard organizing meetings without the phone, though. We've had to resort to carrier pigeons, and they keep disappearing.
What are you speaking to me on? What's that in your hand?
I am not the problem. You are, and you're perpetuating the downfall of mankind. Liberty City was great before phones ruined everything.
Liberty City was a church, a cow pasture, and three houses when the telephone was invented.
Liar!
You're the liar.
Liar. Laszlo's a liar. Laszlo's a liar. I bet that isn't even your real name.
Shut up.
You shut up.
Stupid.
Nanny, nanny, boo-boo, stick your head in doo-doo.
Oh, we're going to commercials.
Is your job affecting your health? Do you become fatigued? Does working take time away from family and social...
Thank you.
smoke if you got him.
What's up?
Sorry, Fernando hasn't paid his bill to our ad sales department. But here's someone who has, and they paid us in... Winter.
What do you mean?
You know, I mean, what about winter? When the wind blows really cold, I mean, you prance about like a ninny waiting for your privates to go blue?
I was born naked, I'm gonna die naked.
And all shriveled up by the sound of it.
Winter was invented by clothing companies. Clothes are unnecessary. They're ugly. Have you ever cooked in the nude?
No, but look, is this leading anywhere? Because, I mean, we've got a lot of other people waiting to talk about real things here.
Nudity is real. Open your eyes. Take off your pants. Come on. Come on, Laszlo, you can be a figurehead for Liberty City interest. We have more members now for the first time since 1977. Nudity is back. A lot of people are into nudity and really understand the spiritual side.
What? Of hanging out with loads of naked chicks? I mean, I see the fun in it, but I just think clothes have distinct advantages, like not accidentally cooking yourself, or when you're working on a building.
We're not swingers. It's not about sex. It's about being one with the world.
All right, dude. Groovy. Hug a rainbow. It's time for a public service announcement from Donald Love.
Hello, I'm Donald Love. Under my guidance, Love Media has emerged as the fastest-growing U.S.-run media conglomerate of the past 5 years, with newspapers, television, and radio stations across the U.S. and the free world. Hear the pop music. You can be sure of independent, quality-led broadcasting every time you tune in. That's why we're the fastest-growing cable supplier and health insurance provider in the Northeast, and why our new satellite in China is something all Americans can be proud of. Here at Love Media, we are proud of what we have done to help America and to help hard-working Americans relax. For investment opportunities or information about our new interactive television service, please go to www.lovemedia.tv.
Ooh, that makes me feel all warm and fuzzy. All right, let's go to line 8. Hello, caller. What's your name?
Bob from Pine Creek.
Hey, what's up, Bob from Pine Creek?
I've been listening to your show. There's always people going on about problems in school. Guns, people showing disrespect to teachers, drugs. People are really ground for crime, ain't they?
I guess it seems that way.
Well, I got a real simple solution. Shut down. Shut down the schools, shut down the problem. No more dead teachers, no more angry students.
Well, but you don't think...
No, I don't, never. Now, listen to me. Certain things, kids these days, they complain a lot. What? Well, not my Johnny. No, sir. I'm learning him the value of good, hard work. Learning him good. Freaks taught him how to clean the bathroom. He left so much one hair on himself, it was off the bed with no dinner. You know what? He went to bed hungry only 20, maybe 30 hours. And he learned. Now, he brings his mother lunch to bed every day. Sleep in. Let me tell you, everyone should have their kids serving up food. He even cooks for the whole family. These days he's getting too big to defend him, so now he's a paralegal raking him home. Seven and making magically $23,000 a year. And on weekends, he doesn't go to the mall, play soccer, feed, or do any of that kind of stuff. No, no, he works the basement of a marketing company making photocopies all night. Hell, he goes to sleep during the day. That's another $8,000 right there. Now, I'm buying me a fast boat trailer. What do you say to that?
Well, it sounds kind of like exploitation to me.
Exploitation? Or kill me. No, he's mine. He's my kid. How can I exploit something I own? Exploitation. Sound like a con. Kids in Russia, they don't work. That's why everything's so messed up over there. Get the wait line for toilet paper. And their space station was made out of silk cream. I'm saying,
really
more living is the American way. Fast. And the only thing more American is that it's work for you.
That sounds a little oppressive, even despotic.
Exactly, by the way. Hit the nail on the head that time. My kid, telling you, shut the school down, make kids work. That book stuff off the 60s anyway.
And doctors, politicians, lawyers, whatever. You know, I can't be bothered to argue with you, but I do feel sorry for your little Johnny, the 7-year-old cook, chimney sweep, paralegal photocopier, because his daddy's an idiot. Let's take a quick break.
Phil and I just had another kid, so of course we need a bigger SUV. Being a mom is hard with soccer, football, and lacrosse practice, so we bought the new Maifatsu Monstrosity. It's so big, we lost little Joey in the back and couldn't find him for an hour. When I'm rushing to the mall or talking...
You are listening to Chatterbox, hosted by me, Laszlo, because I got kicked off the rock station. Let's go over here and talk to somebody about their life. Hello, caller. You're on the air.
Hi, Leslie. My name's Martha. I just love your show. I always listen to you when I'm getting my colon irrigated. I just wanted to say something about the internet. You know, the Parisian superhighway, the World Wide Web?
Yeah, I know all about it.
Isn't it amazing? I mean, it's incredible. I know a lot of people say it's absolutely a load of crap, but I don't think it's so dumb. It's remarkable, I think.
Okay.
I go to a shop, and the name's Laszlo.
I know, Leslie. I'm a regular listener. Well, I don't. I buy it online, and then I can use it in a different format so I can listen to it while I'm dining. It's incredible. I also like chef and cooking and reality, because the internet is really good for my honey. I think it's amazing. I used to go out a lot, but I don't have to go out ever again. It's incredible. I don't envy those kids with their startups and their fast cars. They earn them. The internet has changed my life.
This is really going nowhere. Do you have anything interesting to say at all?
Well, I wanted to see the Declaration of Independence.
That's phenomenal. Probably one of the reasons there's so many single men in this city. All right, let's go over to here to line 79. Hello, you're on Chatterbox. Exciting for you, but what do you want to talk about?
Oh, man, I mean, what else is there? I could go on all day, but you know how it is, don't you, Laszlo?
Not really. I mean, what's your name? What did you call about?
I'm Maria, you know, Maria, like Mamma Mia, only different, you know, but, you know, men, M-E-N, it's a dirty word, only there's only three letters. You know what I mean? I mean, your broadcasters are all the same, aren't you? I mean, I heard about you. You're always out on boys' nights.
Whoa, what are you talking about? I'm married.
You have one of those convenience jobs to protect you, I bet. I know what you're like. You know more about men than I know about leopard skin furniture. So, less of that clever stuff and give me some advice. I mean, come on, I got real problems. You see, okay, I had this boyfriend, and at first, he was real kind to me. He was a real gentleman. A little bit older and everything, but yeah, he treated me really good. And it all went wrong, and so, you know, I found someone else. And he seems real nice, but, you know, he don't talk too much, so I really can't tell if he likes me. Well, I guess what I want to know is, how do you tell if a guy is serious? I mean, you know, he treats me good, but he don't seem real interested in me. You know, he's always working and hanging out with the guys.
What do you mean, like me? What are you insinuating? That he's on the radio? Well, probably not. You're listening to Chatterbox, where your opinion matters, or at least we say that. Let's go over here to line 4. Hello, caller, what's your name?
Jeff the Buck.
Hello, Jeff, what's up?
I wanted to tell you and your listeners about a once-in-a-lifetime chance to make a difference. It's a rally far you can get to far. Starting at 7. Although we'll be getting banners and theme songs all night, all day to prepare for it. Then, when tens of thousands gathered in the park, we're going to march on the town hall. Laszlo, the people have spoken, and they have said no, not in my sense. So folks, if you're listening and want to make a difference, get yourselves down to the park and prepare to bring democracy back to the people.
So what's this rally about, Jeff?
It's about people standing up and being counted. It's about the future. It's about telling those small arms in the suits, no thanks, not in my town. Not while I have a breath in my body and hope in my soul. I will not, I cannot let this pass.
Thank you.
fool with the law.
You have a question?
Dude, I call every day and I... And
thanks, what's up?
Oh man, I'm serious, really great. You're like a total inspiration.
And exactly what have I inspired you about?
Well, okay, right now I live at home, but pretty soon, like next week, dude, I'm moving out. It's the big 4-0, and it's just time to go.
Okay, did you have anything relevant to say?
Yeah, dude, that B dude was bogus. Really bogus. That's all. Great show, Laszlo.
I appreciate that. That's why I went to broadcasting school. All right, when we come back from these messages that help supplement my meager salary, we're going to talk to Reed Tucker for a great interview. We'll be right back.
A good shoe starts from the ground up. At Aris, we make high-quality footwear. In fact, you can find Aris running shoes in over 140 countries around the world. In the past, there's been some criticism about our workers. That's why I'm here at one of the Aris factories so you can meet some of them. Excuse me, sir. Do you enjoy your job here?
It's fun. We get to play with knives.
I see. Is there a real sense of teamwork?
My friend Joey sewed his hands together.
Wow. You're learning some real skills. How about the salary and benefits?
Yesterday, I made $1.
See, that's the kind of dedication we have to our employees and the quality of our shoes. Aris Running Shoes. Always running from something.
Buying a gift for the guy that has everything? Log on to PetsOvernight.com.
We've got exotic pets galore, including tigers, cobras, manatees, and white rhinos. All delivered overnight. PetsOvernight.com, delivering little bundles of love in a box directly to your door.
All right, now joining us in the studio, we have a very special guest. His new book, Karate and Digestion, has been on the top 100 self-help books for the past 3 weeks. He is the founder of Now and Zen Dojo and Organic Food Market in Trenton. His name is Reed Tucker. Welcome to Chatterbox, Reed.
Why, thank you, Laszlo. It certainly is an honor to be here today.
So tell me, Reed, where did you...
I got just the thing for you.
Masticating cow, so I really don't enjoy chewing damp hay and prancing around in leggings, shouting,
Okay, that though, I'm warning you this time. Do not make me angry. Bad for my karma. It will definitely be bad for your karma. I studied the martial arts so I could stand up to bullies just like you, and I encourage everyone listening out there on Chatterbox to buy my book and learn how organic food and martial arts can help.
And I encourage anyone who needs a doorstop or a booster seat to buy it as well. Let's see who's on the phones.
Let go.
Hello, caller.
Carnivore, why don't you go gnaw on a bone like a gorilla, Laszlo? Our ancestors didn't eat chicken wings. They lived at one with nature and their ecosystem, subsisting on diet of nuts, berries, and leafy vegetables.
Yes, and they threw stones at their own shadow and died of old age and fear at 24.
Laszlo, your soul is eternal. But let me answer the question. When I'm in trouble or tempted by those all-you-can-eat breakfast buffets, bacon.
Piece of bacon in here.
Laszlo, I go back to the business. I start the day with fruity beverage, some meditation, and 6 hours of yoga. Next, I go open up a shop, now and then, and drink 2 pints of canned.
And who wants a steak after that? Okay, next caller, you are on Chatterbox with Reed Tucker.
Yo, Reed.
Okay, first thing first, man, you need to stop the next stupid thing. The best attack I've found is to just run away. That way you'll still fear me.
Language. Not the time.
she'll make it so. Dragon's dance.
Hey, yeah! Oh! Oh, yeah, no!
The death can steal in one piece. Thanks for coming on the show.
Okay, but as a mockery, we can no more.
Oh, I broke the teeth in it. Go for it. Tofu with her bean curves at me.
Be very funny now, though. You can make fun of me because all the bumps going here. Downright disgraceful.
Yes, it makes me talk like this. Okay, well, let's go land the road. This is Chatterbox. We're on the air.
Hey, Laszlo. That last guy was a lunatic. Why don't you take him up for a mistake, Steven? Now, wacko, you had going on about killing. What a moron. I mean, just read his newspaper. The evils of artificial sweeteners and soda pop, Roswell, it's all part of the government's propaganda plan. I might as well wear a stud like this. Their propaganda right into my brain. Come on, do you honestly believe the NSA's echelon system isn't already reading emails and recording conversations? It's all designed to frighten us so we don't complain about our rights being taken away. Whatever boogeyman they come up with today.
Well, I mean, you realize that the government listens to this station.
Free Kevin!
All right, we're talking about short guys, killer bees, the Magna Carta, Well, the red light on the wall is flashing, which means that the owner of the station has an important announcement to make. Let's go live to his office.
Hello. My name is Donald Love. You're listening to the Love Media Station. Enjoy.
Wow, man, that was deep. I really like working here. The station, it feels like my second family. Except that we have a snack machine. And I tell you, working here beats the hell out of digging sewage ditches outside Kuala Lumpur. All right, let's go to the phones. Hello, caller. You're on show.
Well, little man, I was with that when you talked to earlier. I mean, do these guys realize how wussy they sound? I mean, they have the nerve to call crackers this, and they say aluminium instead of aluminum. I mean, what's up with that? They all think they sound so smart with a little funny accent. I mean, I got something for them. Speak English, you limey moron.
Well, you know, I think they were speaking English before we were. The people over here were speaking Shoshone and Cherokee.
Man, Cherokee's spared, man. And another thing, man, what's up with them calling soccer football? Man, you ever watch soccer? Man, that's a boring game, man. I'll tell you what soccer is. Soccer's for little girls, man. Football, now that's an American sport. It teaches you good, wholesome American values, man, like stealing other people's land by force and wearing tight pants while you do it.
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about being a man, Laszlo. Something you wouldn't know anything about from the sound of things. I'll tell you, I bet you play wimpy stuff like touch football and basketball.
Look, I'm running around the court there with a ball and I'm 7'3".
I'm telling you, man, I only play men's sports. Like football. Hopscotch?
That's a girl's game.
Man, that ain't a girl's game, man. Not rugby hopscotch. Man, get me in the scrum and I'll date. I'll take anybody's dance. I'm the hopscotch master. I got wide kill hopscotch. You know what I'm saying?
It will be a miracle. I guarantee it. Fernando's new beginnings. We turn an ending into a new beginning.
Mom, there's a package for you.
Sorry, what's this? How sweet.
But you will
puppy.
Everybody loves a puppy. And now you can ship one anywhere just by logging on to PetsOvernight.com. PetsOvernight.com. Delivering little bundles of love in a box.
And who says that e-commerce isn't a brilliant idea? All right, speaking of brilliant, you're listening to Chatterbox with me, Laszlo. Let's go over here to the phones and see what's plaguing Liberty City. Oh, caller, you're on the air.
Wow, I got through. Laszlo, I think your last few callers are a perfect example of manners in the city. People are rude, and they don't seem to care